There's a beautiful parable shared by a great Jewish sage. He tells a story of a very expensive hotel which cost $120,000 a day. If you break it down, it costed $5,000 an hour. Only the wealthiest of people could afford to stay there. Now, a very wealthy person once came to stay at the hotel for a day, and he sees an old friend from school there, someone whom he had never thought would amount to much. And he turns to him and he says, "What are you doing here? How many minutes are you staying here for?" The fellow answered, "I have been here for a few years already, in fact." His response was, "What? I'm extremely wealthy and I can't afford to stay here more than 24 hours. And you've been here for a few years?" The fellow responded, "Yes, you see, I'm the manager here. I stay here for free. And not only do I stay for free, I actually get paid to be here." The moral of the story relates to this time of year. You see, on Rosh Hashanah, the book of life and prosperity is open. The world is like an expensive hotel, so to speak. And from the divine point of view, we need to earn our stay on this precious earth through righteous behavior. But here's the thing. If one's mindset in this life is that we are here to maximize our own pleasure and to optimize our stay in this hotel of life, focusing only on our needs, on our well-being and comfort, then the cost of living is very high indeed, and our stay is commensurate to our earning and spending power. If, however, like the hotel manager in the story, our passion in life and the purpose of our existence is linked to making the stay of others on this earth as comfortable, as enjoyable, and meaningful as possible, then not only do we not need to earn our stay in the hotel, we are rewarded for our efforts to serve the well-being of others. This simple parable reminds us of the important spiritual truth that from the divine perspective, the most noble life one can live is one lived in the service of others and the greater good. So as we enter the period of reckoning this year, let us resolve to be kinder, to be gentler to others. Let us increase in our acts of generosity, goodness, and kindness. Let's allocate more of our time, energy, and resources this year to the betterment of community and society. Let's define and design our mission in life more in terms of what we give than what we take, and more in terms of what we share than what we make. And in this merit, may we each be inscribed and sealed into the Book of Life and Prosperity.